What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And today's topic is true or full asynchronous service. So this is a little advanced topic, and it's actually at a following up video of another video that we made called Asynchronous versus Synchronous Client. So I do recommend watching that video first to explain what is the difference between synchronous and asynchronous client from the client perspective, and then come back to this video to know how to build an actual true asynchronous service. And we're going to talk about what is that, what is exactly an asynchronous service or true asynchronous service, what are the advantages and all that cool stuff. So stay tuned, guys. All right. If you guys are new to my channel, obviously, consider subscribing. I talk about software engineering concept by example here, and there's a lot of software engineering. I specialize in GIS in general, so geographic information systems, so that's my specialty, but I'd also talk about other software engineering topics in general. So if you're interested, subscribe and hit that bell icon to get notified. All right, and with that, let's get to it. All right, so let's first explain asynchronous service, how it actually works, right? And this is a little JavaScript code this is the client itself, right? So this code lives in the client, whereas I have a service that I have been written. Someone wrote this service, could be Node.js, could be WCF, sorry, WCF, Windows Communication Foundation. So any REST service, essentially, that what it does, it's very simple. It takes a number and it tells you if it's a prime or not. Obviously, this is a very expensive operation, right? For not so much for 5 and 6 or 7, but for huge numbers, it takes a lot of computation. All right, so we want to know, so we have authored this service exists there in the backend, right? So you give it a number using get, and it tells you that, hey, this is a prime or not, true or false, very simple, right? And we're using async await to make the client asynchronous. So this is that's why I recommend watching that video first to really learn what an asynchronous client versus a synchronous client. Right. So yeah, so we have an asynchronous client here, but the service is still a synchronous, right? Still waits for it. All right. So yeah, it's prime. So that's the function. That function takes a number and does a send request, makes a get request, very simple, and pass in the n equal number. And obviously this is a generator function, so it waits for you can still execute a little stuff, so the UI is unblocked, but after a while you get the value, right? But the client still really doesn't know what's happening. So all the client knows is that, hey, I send a request, I don't know what's happening, right? Like, it's just the server's processing this thing, it didn't give me any answer, it didn't fail. Right, it didn't give me any failure, so I can try catch and listen to failures. But there's no failures, there's no progress. I can't know anything about this. Right, you make a request, and that's it. You forget about it. You wait for it. You have to wait, or essentially, wait in a sense to receive a request from a response from the server. Right, you can still do UI stuff. Right, but you're waiting, essentially, and you're waiting for a result. You can't tell the user anything about what's happening. Oh, I have processed 50%, I have processed 60%, oh, I'm done, I'm not done. You can't tell how long this has been done, especially with long processing operations and services. This is really critical. So that's a synchronous service. That's a classical service that we all write. This is a RESTful service, right? So you make a request, you wait for it. The server doesn't really tell you anything. However, you can make your code a little smarter, right, to build a true asynchronous service. So what it does, it's essentially just a little more code at the server level. So what you introduce, and instead of just having the REST call as prime, the function, you add another one, which is essentially the jobs concept or work orders concept jobs, right? So what do you do instead? The user or the client will make a request to the service is prime, but you immediately, the service immediately returns a job ID. It says, hey, all right, I get you, I got you, right? I got you this number, okay, I got your request. I'm processing it, right? But here's a job ID. It's like this order confirmation number for if you book a travel, if you book a hotel or something, right? You want to check in with those guys, right? So this is the same concept, essentially. So the server will take that request. We'll start executing that prime job, right? So it's, I'm executing that, but here's the job ID, number 888, all right? And check with me anytime. I'm going to tell you more information about that job if you check with me. He says, okay, how can I check with you? There you go. You can call this REST endpoint. That's a different REST endpoint. /job/ID. Give me the ID. And I'll tell you if it's done, if it's processing. And I'll tell you very cool information. A lot of status. I can tell you really cool stuff about your job. And just like that, this have become really powerful, right? This true asynchronous service. So the client doesn't have to wait anymore, right? You can just close the client. If you have the job, you can persist it in the client and then boot the client again and then retrieve the job. It says, hey, by the way, I just I have this job ID stored locally in my I keep forgetting this database name. Anyway, this SQLite, sorry. Yeah, this on my SQLite, I have this job ID. Hey, server, I think I crashed. My Chrome has crashed, but I have this job ID. Is this job done? Can you tell me more information about that? Hey, yeah, sure. This job has been still processing. You requested this job in this date and this time by this user, and it's still processing. It's 70% done. The prime number you give, the number you give me, it's a huge. So I'm still processing a lot of stuff. So here's the result. But yeah, keep checking with me, right? And you can build the client in a way to have this function check job, essentially, which is makes a request, simple request, and it tells you like the progress. And in this case, I just added the progress and done, and you can check that if it's done or not. So it's just essentially a JSON response, which tells you really cool information about the job. And just like that, you can build a true asynchronous service. All right, so it's, sometimes it's really beneficial to build a true asynchronous service. Obviously, disadvantages, you have to write a lot more code. Is it worth it or not? Do you even have a huge job that executes at the server? Sometimes your request is always like a persistent to the database and you return, right? But yeah. But with that job, with the asynchronous, you have to maintain a table or database. You have to store your job somewhere, right? Your code has to read those jobs. Your code has to persist and purge those jobs after, like, I don't know, 120 days. You can't keep your jobs forever if they are done, right? So there are lots of disadvantages and advantages. But I pass this question to you, back to you guys. What do you think? Would you build a true asynchronous service or you were sticking with a synchronous service? Because nothing wrong with both, right? You can choose when, what do you exactly need? And have you built ever an asynchronous service? What was your experience with it? Tell us in the comment section below. And an example of an asynchronous server is actually our Jaya server with the geoprocessing tools. This is a very good example where we use the ArcGIS, where Azure uses the ArcGIS service server technology with a true asynchronous service. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I hope it makes sense. And let us know in the comment section, what do you think about this technology or this pattern? I'm not going to call it technologies. Everything is available there. But yeah, guys, let me know. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'm going to see you in the next one. You guys stay awesome. Bye-bye.